Conrad Stoltz, 3 times Xterra world champion, 2-time Olympian, South African, and proud of it. I grew up in Pretoria, South Africa, and I started the first bicycle I rode with no training wheels. I was 3 years old, and my dad took me to the local golf course, and he put me on the putting green with this little bike with balloon tires this big. And he put me on the bike, he gave me a push, and there I started. I started riding, and within a couple of days, the golfers were complaining that I was turning too sharp and my pedals were making divots in the putting greens, so they didn't want me to ride on the golf course anymore. So I think my learning curve was really steep, and I fell in love with bikes right away, and my whole career since then, I've always been obsessed with bicycles. When I was 7 years old, I started BMX racing, and my parents took me to Back of the Moon outside of Pretoria. It was a BMX racing track, and I raced there for probably 3-4 years BMX. And when I was 14, my mom bought me half a road bike for my birthday, and I had to buy the other half. And that's where my passion for road cycling took off. I took out a license and I raced as a licensed junior schoolboy. Of course, I'd been running very competitively actually from the age of about 10 at school track and field. I did the 1500 and the 3000. I ran cross country during the winter, so I've basically been running since I was 8. Racing BMX and road bikes from junior high and high school. So when mountain bikes came out and they were a very far-fetched idea, I was 15 years old, and my mom bought me a kind of a mountain bike, and it was pretty amazing to me how you could just ride anywhere. There's no roads. You can just basically take a little footpath and see where it goes and see how much of it you can ride. And I spent my days when the other kids in school were smoking behind the classrooms and enjoying things that young kids enjoy, like going out and drinking and hanging out with girls. I was obsessed with bikes and always rode bikes. My parents were both very sportive, and my dad ran his whole life and he did gymnastics, and my mom was also a runner. So my dad and I did our first triathlon together. I was 14 years old, and he had a bike, and we were training together and running together, and we started in 1988 our first triathlon, and he still to this day cycles. He's got a specialized Epic that I gave him for Christmas, and every Sunday he rides. He's 66 years old now. He had cancer a couple of years ago, and he completely overcame that and used the bike as therapy, really, to prove to himself his well-being and his health and his enjoyment of life and the outdoors. So whenever I'm on the farm with my parents, every Sunday I go ride with my dad, and it's pretty special. When I started my career as a professional triathlete at the age of 18 in Pretoria, South Africa, when triathlon was still, it wasn't an Olympic sport, South Africa was still boycotted globally because of apartheid. I would never have imagined being able to wear the rainbow stripes, or to be able to ride the best bikes in the world and get paid for it. So being able to represent the best in the world with the rainbow stripes, and the best in the world with the brand of bikes that I've been riding for the past 9 years, is a dream come true, really. If my career ended tomorrow, I would be happy with what I had achieved, and be really proud, and can't wait to have grandkids to tell the stories and show the race numbers, and I'll frame my jerseys and keep a couple of old bikes to remind me of the great things and the great memories that sport has allowed me to have throughout my career. Coming from the background that I come from, I think it's quite special. Well, I met Ned Overend at my first Xterra in 2001. My first year racing Xterra, I was actually a road triathlete, and I went to America to start racing Xterra, and I didn't have a mountain bike at the time. I only had a road bike. So I borrowed mountain bikes before every triathlon. I would borrow a mountain bike, and the bikes were all really bad. The first one was a soft ride with the beam, and had a flexi stem, and I had my own pedals, and I had a pair of tires, those yellow Michelin Pythons. I traveled with that, and then I borrowed bikes, and that's how I was racing. And at my very first race, I was second on the bike and I dropped the chain and I was busy getting the train out of the front derailleur. And Ned Overend and Steve Larson came blowing by me on the trail. And I eventually caught them on the run. And what really struck me is after the race, both Steve and Ned Overend came over to me and said, "Hey, welcome to Xterra, and we're really glad to have you. And it's a great pleasure. And you were such a good runner. Are you going to do more of these races?" And I was really struck by their humility and their friendship. And we competed every weekend, or every time we raced Xterra throughout the season. And despite the borrowed bikes, I won the USA series, and Ned must have seen something he liked, because just after the USA championships he said, "Hey Conrad, would you like to ride for Specialized?" And I said sure, thinking that often there's a lot of talk when it comes to sponsorship and it doesn't always pan out. And a week before World Championships there was a brand new Specialized M5 dual suspension mountain bike with a helmet and new shoes, and the first tubeless tires I've ever owned, tubeless wheels, and to me it was it's like riding a motorbike. And I won World Championships by 10 minutes, and Ned Overend was fourth that year. And so Ned is like, "Just tell me where to send the contract." And I wasn't sure how much to, I had no idea what to ask for, so I asked Ned, "How much should I ask for?" And Ned said, "Ask X," and I asked for X, and that's what I got. And That's been my relationship ever since with the Specialized. I never looked back, and Ned has been especially a real inspiration to me since then. The first time I won Xterra in 2001, I told myself I want to win this world title 5 times. And since then I've had, I won 3 world titles, and I've had a number of disappointments, some of them mechanical, some of it was my own fault. But I want to put my name on the sport properly by winning 5 world titles. So I think in 2 more runs, if I have good clean runs, I think I can win 2 more titles. And I enjoy the sport. I'm really passionate about what I do, and I dream about 5 world titles.